Trust your first impression. What do you see?
Tree.
A tree. Mm-hmm. Tell me more. What kind of tree do you see?
Tall. Mm-hmm. Tall tree.
Mm-hmm. Does it have a lot of leaves, or is it
on the top?
On the top.
On the top.
Mm-hmm. Where are you in reference to this tree? Are you below it or above it?
Below.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more. What else do you see around? Look down at your feet. Can you see anything?
I'm not getting it.
Mm-hmm. What are you getting? Just a tree? Let's see how you're looking at this tree. I want you to focus on the observer of this tree. What do you look like or feel like?
I don't see anything.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that you can move in this place? See if you can move around and get a different perspective of where you are. See if you could turn around. Tell me what you're feeling. The more you speak, the more you'll see.
I can't see anything.
Mm-hmm.
It's just light.
It's just light.
Light.
Okay. So let's look at this light if you're just seeing light. What color is the light? Take a look at this light. Mm-hmm.
Can't see.
Mm-hmm.
Can't see.
Well, you're not seeing with your eyes. You're seeing with your senses. So when you tell me that you see light, I want you to observe this light because you're seeing something. So I want you to then click on to the other senses. It's like when you walk into a dark room and you sense that somebody's there although you can't see them. And then they turn on the lights and you see there's a whole room full of people and you know it. I want you to hone in on that sense that allows you to know where you are. So tell me what you're feeling as you're sensing this light. What comes to mind? What words or ideas come into your head?
Nervous.
Nervous. Very good. Perfect. You're doing great. Let's find out why you're nervous. I want you to absorb all of that and let's get into character and see what's happening.
My heart's beating fast.
My heart's beating fast. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Keep going. You're doing great. Is it a good nervous or a bad nervous? How does it feel?
I'm not scared.
Mm-hmm. Is it a happy nervous?
Happy nervous.
All right. So as you're happy nervous, let's find out why you're so happy. What's the first thing that popped into your mind? What's the happiness about?
The light.
The light.
I see light.
How does this light make you feel?
I feel so happy.
I feel so happy. Are you usually in this light? Or have you just visited this light?
I'm here.
Absorb all of your feelings. Tell me everything you feel.
I'm here.
How long have you been gone?
So long.
Oh,
my heart's so happy.
Are you by yourself, or do you feel that there's someone there waiting for you?
I don't know.
So let's enjoy that light. What are the feelings that you're feeling?
Joy.
Joy.
I feel peace.
Where do you feel this love?
My heart is so full.
So let's see what you do with this beautiful feeling. Let's continue on your path. And tell me what happens next. What do you see now?
Just light.
Just light.
White light.
White light. So let's see if we can find someone who's been waiting for you for a long time to come back. What do you see?
Grandmother.
What'd she look like now?
She's just light.
Is this Kitesh?
Yes.
What does Kitesh say to her granddaughter?
She's hugging.
Go ahead and hug her back. I'm going to help you. Put your arms around Kitesh. Give her a strong hug. Go ahead and talk to her. What would you like to tell her?
The last time I hugged her, I knew I wasn't gonna see her again here in this earth. But I knew we would be together someday. I love her so much.
Allow Kitesh to talk to you. Kitesh, talk to your granddaughter.
I love her.
Go ahead and talk to her, your granddaughter. What would you like to tell her?
I miss her. She's doing good.
Tell her what you've been doing.
Having fun.
kind of fun are you having?
Lots of parties. Lots of friends.
What are those parties like in the light?
They're great. They're great. I get to be with everyone. There's love. I love everyone.
Are you able to help Alexandra?
Yes.
How do you help her?
I watch over her. Protect her. I love her.
Have you helped her with her relationships?
Yes.
What would you like to tell her about that?
She needs to trust her intuition.
Kitesh, do you know if she has a twin soul waiting for her?
Yes.
Tell her how she could meet him.
He's coming. He knows her.
He already knows her? From a different life? Or from this life?
Both.
Both. What's the best way for her to prepare to meet her twin soul?
Heal. Trust.
Will you help her with that?
Yes.
Thank you. Do you have any other advice for her?
Stay strong. You know your path. You're a healer.
And let me touch your forehead. What would you like to tell your grandmother, Alexandra?
I miss her.
Tell her.
I miss her. I love her so much. I know she watches over me. I know.
Anything else you would like to tell her?
I know we're part of each other.
Very good. Very good. So say goodbye to your grandmother. Allow yourself to be disconnected from your grandmother. And now I want you to go drifting and floating through that light. Drifting and floating. Allow yourself to drift. And let's go now to another time and another place where there's more information to help you. In the very best way. You're drifting and floating through time and space. Allow yourself to go to the places, time and place that gives you the most information. Be there now. Look around. Is it daytime or nighttime?
Daytime.
Daytime. Are you indoors or outdoors?
Indoors.
Indoors. Describe to me where you are. What is this place?
It's tight.
It's tight. You feel like you're enclosed in something? Or can you move around?
I can move around.
What position are you in when you're there?
Standing up.
You're standing up. Very good. I want you to reach out and see if you could feel around you. What is this place?
Just walls.
walls? What are these walls made of? What's the texture like?
Cold.
Cold.
Mm-hmm. Cold. Gray walls.
Are these artificial walls? Or are they made out of something natural?
Natural.
Mm-hmm. What would you say they're made out of?
Probably cement or stone.
Okay, a fireplace, cement or stone.
Cement, stone.
Mm-hmm. Are you inside the fireplace or outside?
No fireplace. Mm-hmm. No fire. It's just walls.
It's walls. Mm-hmm. Is there a way out of this place?
Cold.
Mm-hmm. You're cold. I want you to notice your body. Are you male or female here?
Female.
Mm-hmm. And you say you're cold. What are you wearing there that has you so cold?
A gray dress.
A gray dress. Is it long or short?
Just knees.
Up to your knees. Mm-hmm.
Short sleeves.
Short sleeves.
My elbow.
Mm-hmm. Are you young or are you old there? How old do you feel?
My teens.
Your teens. Mm-hmm. So let's find out why you're in this place. What is this place you're in? Use your first impression. What is this place?
They put me here.
Mm-hmm. Who's they?
Nazis.
The Nazis. Mm-hmm. What is this place?
Like a jail.
A jail. Mm-hmm. Tell me more. Are you by yourself?
By myself.
Mm-hmm. What are you feeling there besides cold?
I'm scared.
Mm-hmm. Where's your family?
They took them.
And why are you by yourself?
They test me.
What did they test you with?
My brain.
Your brain. What did they do?
Put a bowl, a metal bowl on my brain.
They put a metal bowl on your brain?
Wires.
With wires? And what did they do?
They test me.
How does that feel? What are they testing you for? There must be something special about you.
They know I know.
Mm-hmm. What is it that you know? It must be very special for them to keep you there. Mm-hmm. Tell me what you know.
Psychic?
Mm-hmm. Can you communicate?
Telepathy?
Mm-hmm. So are they using you to harness your power?
Electricity? Electricity through my body.
Mm-hmm. Oh. What happens to you when you have this electricity?
Oh. They're harming me.
They're harming you. You can just watch it. You don't have to be in the body. Observe it. Be an observer and watch it happen. What happens when they test you? They're slowly killing you?
They're trying to get information. I'm not going to give it to them.
Mm-hmm. How do you keep from giving them information?
I go within.
Mm-hmm. Do you hide somewhere?
I go within my heart.
Mm-hmm. You go within your heart.
I go within my heart.
Tell me more.
They can do whatever they want to me. They're not gonna get me.
They can do whatever they want to you, but they're not gonna get me. Mm-hmm. What are they trying to get from you?
Information.
Mm-hmm.
About the other soldiers.
About the other soldiers?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. They're using you as a spy?
Mental.
Mm-hmm.
Mental.
Mm-hmm. Are you able to remote view the other soldiers?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And when you do this remote viewing, what do you see? You see the other soldiers.
I don't want to harm them.
You don't want to harm them.
No.
Mm-hmm. Who are these other soldiers?
U.S.
The U.S. soldiers?
Mm-hmm. U.S.
So how did they find out about you?
I feel it.
What do you feel?
I feel their pain.
You feel their pain? The soldiers?
Yes, the U.S. soldiers.
Mm-hmm. And where were you born?
Poland.
Poland.
Polish.
Mm-hmm. How long have been they experimenting on you?
A year.
How did they find you?
They heard about me.
They heard about you. Mm-hmm. Are there any others like you?
Yes.
How many?
50.
50 of them. Are they all children?
No, not all.
Mm-hmm. Do you talk to each other?
Through the mind.
The mind?
Through the mind.
Through the mind you talk to each other. Mm-hmm. What is your name there?
Anita.
So Anita, let's see what happens next. I want you to close that scene and let's move to another scene where something important is happening. Tell me what's happening.
Electric shock.
They're giving you electric shocks? Mm-hmm. What else?
I can't take anymore.
I can't take anymore.
I'm gonna go.
All right.
I'm gonna go to the other side. I don't like this anymore.
Mm-hmm. Anita, before you go, let's do something very important here. I want you to hold on before you go, and I'm gonna put my hand on your chest. And I want you to give me all of that suffering. Give me all of that suffering. Allow it to just flow out of you. All of that suffering. I want you to let go of all of those feelings that you had against those Nazis, against those people that were doing this to you. They didn't know any better. They thought they would get information from you, but you were a lot stronger, weren't you?
Yes.
A lot stronger. You were able to win by just allowing yourself to disconnect from them. Give it all to me. Know that you work success. You knew exactly what to do to keep that information from them, didn't you? Mm-hmm. Tell me when I have all of that pain that you've been holding.
No.
Give it all to me. Do I have it all? All right, I'm going to take that and send it to the universe. Now, Anita, before you go, what would you like to fill your soul with before you leave?
Love and light.
Let's put lots of love and light. Put lots of love and light. Allow that to flow through you, knowing that they could not harm your soul. They could not harm your soul, could they?
Never.
All right, I'm going to touch your forehead so we could seal that love and light in there. Feel it sealing it. Now, Anita, take your last breath. Allow yourself to just leave that body and tell me where you go to.
The light.
The light. Very good. So Anita, as you're traveling to the light, I want you to look at that lifetime. Every lifetime has a mission and a purpose. Why did you choose to live that lifetime?
To
like
learn.
That?
To learn.
What did you learn?
I had a happy family.
And that you have a happy family?
I had a happy family. I had love.
You had love in your family.
I was able not only to protect myself, but also to protect the people that were doing good.
So you protected them by not giving out that information?
Yes.
Do you feel proud of yourself?
Yes, and I protected them remotely. I protected them.
Were you able to project your love to them?
Yes.
Very good. What lessons did you learn about yourself in that lifetime?
Strong.
You're a very strong person, aren't you?
I survived.
You survived. So let's leave that scene and let's go continue into that light. Allow your soul to go into that light. And tell me, what happens next? Who meets you there?
Everyone.
Who's up there with you?
The angels.
The angels. Who's there? Can you pick them out?
They're all there. Archangel Michael.
Archangel Michael, yes.
Raphael. Archangel Gabriel.
Ariel.
Zachiel. They're all there.
Zachiel. Very good. What do they say to you?
Oh, they're patting me on the back.
They're patting you on the back.
Yes.
What is it that you do with the angels? With you.
I work with them.
Are you part of their team?
Yes.
So what was the reason why you had to choose that life of a Polish girl? What work were you doing for the angels
then? Light.
You were giving light?
Light.
You were in a very dark place, Anita. Very dark place.
Yeah.
Your body suffered quite a bit, didn't it? But it's okay.
It's over.
Did you see how much light you gave in that lifetime?
Yes. It was needed. They needed it.
They needed that light. You saved a lot of people, didn't you?
Oh, yes.
Very good.
Yeah. They needed to go back to their families.
They needed to go back to their families.
Yes.
And what is your family?
Light.
The light. Very good. So let's see what happens next. Continue on. What happens after you meet with your angels? Where do you go?
The happy place.
The happy place. What does this happy place look like?
Oh. It's paradise.
Paradise.
Everything glows white.
What else do you see there besides white?
Good souls. White souls.
Take a look at yourself. What do you look like now?
I'm light.
Do you have a particular color?
White.
White.
Glow like gold.
Is that a very...
I see wings.
You see wings. Take a look.
Wings. White wings.
White wings. Are you an angel too? What name do you have in the angel realm?
Arishka?
What do they call you?
Ari?
Is that your angel name?
Yes.
So what do you do when you don't have a body on Earth? You watch over?
Earth.
You watch over Earth.
Watch over Earth.
What's happening with Earth that you need to watch over?
Oh, it needs light.
It needs light? Mm-hmm.
Healing.
What else?
People need courage.
Mm-hmm.
They need courage. They need to see the miracles that happen to them every day.
These miracles every day? Mm-hmm. Tell me about some of these miracles.
They are surrounded by light.
Mm-hmm.
But they don't see.
Why is that?
They take things for granted.
Mm-hmm.
God loves them. They cause themselves pain. And they don't have to, they don't need to.
Why do humans cause themselves pain?
They get too much in their heads.
Mm-hmm.
And their material things don't matter.
How should the humans be?
They should help each other more and love each other more. Be more conscious of their actions.
Mm-hmm.
They hurt each other.
Like they hurt you when you were Anita?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
They're mean
mm-hmm.
to each other. They should not do that. That hurts us.
How does it hurt you, Ari?
Because it brings the energy down.
Is this the energy of Mother Earth?
And the angels.
And the angels too.
Because we love you. We want the best for you. We want to see everyone happy.
Mm-hmm. How do the angels help the humans?
We send out light, vibrations. We're always behind you and we watch over you.
How do you help us if we call you?
Sometimes you don't even have to call. We're there.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to ask for help.
Mm-hmm. Why do we have to ask for help?
Because that is the law.
That's the law. Can you tell me a little bit about God's law?
Free will
mm-hmm.
on Mother Earth.
Free will on Mother Earth. Can you tell me about how this developed, this free will? Why do we have it?
That's how it was set up.
Mm.
From the beginning.
So no one can get involved with us unless we allow it?
The dark, they try. They try to do everything. Put you in a lower state.
Mm-hmm. A vibration?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But we're here. We're here. We're here to protect you.
How many angels are there?
So many.
Mm-hmm.
Too many to count.
Do they have different categories, these angels? Do they do different things?
Yes.
Tell me about the different things that the angels do.
Some protect you.
Mm-hmm.
Some help you.
Mm-hmm.
Some heal you. They give light and love.
Mm-hmm.
High energy vibration.
Do they help us in our dreams when we're sleeping?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what happens when someone is sleeping and one of these dark energies is trying to hurt us? What do they do?
They can't.
They can't.
We're there.
Mm-hmm.
But ask more, ask more.
So before you go to sleep, ask for the angels to protect you.
Always.
Mm-hmm.
Always ask for us. Always know we are there. We're here.
Mm-hmm.
To be in service to you and the Divine Source.
Mm-hmm. And why is it that you've chosen to help the humans?
I love them.
Mm.
I love them. I want to save them.
So let me ask you something, Ari. Why did you choose to incarnate as a human if you couldn't help like an angel?
I'm in the middle. I'm in the light.
Mm-hmm.
I'm spreading.
Spreading the light.
Light.
Mm-hmm.
But they... humans hurt me.
Humans hurt you.
Yes, they hurt me. My feelings here on Earth.
They hurt your feelings here on Earth. Are these the Nazis that hurt you?
No, even now.
Even now, okay. Tell me about that, Ari.
They don't know what they're doing.
Mm. Tell me more.
I'm here to help with the shift.
You're here to help with the shift?
Shift.
Can you tell me about this shift? What's happening? I hear about this all the time. What's going on?
We are ascending. Into a new world order.
You're sending a new world order?
Mm-hmm. Divine. Divine world order.
A divine world order. Mm-hmm. And what does this divine world order mean?
Shedding the darkness.
Mm-hmm.
People will be happier.
Mm-hmm.
Have a higher vibration and live in the light.
Mm-hmm. Is this shift going to be in our three-dimensional world? Are we going to continue with our cars and our houses and our jobs? Or is it different?
It's different.
Mm-hmm. How is that?
It will be lighter.
Lighter.
And not as much stress.
Mm-hmm. Will we continue to have the bodies that we have now?
The bodies will be lighter.
Mm-hmm.
We will live longer.
What will we eat?
Slowly not have to eat.
Mm, so we don't need to eat anymore?
Slowly.
Slowly.
Energy.
We'll be eating energy?
We will be energy.
Ah, I see. Mm-hmm. I would assume the angels don't eat.
No.
Mm-hmm. What will we do when with these light bodies? How would we fill our days?
You will be able to transcend.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Manifest.
Mm-hmm.
Manifest house.
Mm-hmm.
Vehicle. If you want to.
Mm-hmm.
But people will be kinder to each other. More loving. And there's healing. No disease.
Mm-hmm.
No hurting each other anymore.
No hurting each other anymore. Have some people already gone into this shift?
They're getting there.
Mm-hmm. How will we know when we're there?
You'll know. You will know, there's no doubt about it.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
You'll feel lighter, happier. There's more love.
More love. That's a wonderful thing.
It's coming soon.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Who will help us with this shift?
All the healers that are on this planet Earth at this time. Divine Source has us working on it as well.
Mm-hmm. So each person knows what their mission is?
Yes, and extraterrestrials.
And extraterrestrials. How would they, what's their role in the shift?
They're all part of and connected with each other.
Will they be visiting us?
They're here.
They're here. How do we know they're here? We can't see them.
We feel them.
We feel them. How does it feel to feel an extraterrestrial near you?
You dream. You dream. Mm-hmm. And good.
They feel good. What do they look like?
There's different mm-hmm. ones.
Will there be fear if we see them?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
They can't reveal themselves yet.
Mm-mm. We've been kind of scared by movies and things.
Movies.
About them.
Mm-hmm. Don't watch them.
Don't watch the movies.
Don't watch them. They're lying to you.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me more about this? How to prepare for it?
Trust.
Trust.
Believe. Faith.
Mm-hmm. Will there be any God. Will there be any changes on the earth? Any shifts of land masses or anything like that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me about that?
But we won't be here.
We won't be here?
No, we won't be here.
So we don't have to worry about it?
No.
Mm-hmm. Will anybody be caught in it that isn't ascending?
The non-believers.
The non-believers. So the ones that believe will automatically be part of the group ascending?
They have the faith.
Mm-hmm.
They have the love in their hearts. That is why they can ascend.
Mm-hmm. How many are expected to ascend when this happens?
Millions.
Millions. That's a lot.
1 million, 2 million.
2 million? Well, there's a lot more people on the earth. There's billions of people. What happens to all the others?
They're not ready yet.
They're not ready. So it's really not that many compared to the entire population.
There's still time.
Mm-hmm. Are people waking up quickly?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Are sessions like this helping?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me how they're helping?
Spread the word.
Spread the word.
Spread the light. Spread the love. Hold them in your thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
No matter what, be yourself. Be who you are.
Mm-hmm. Authentic.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So don't try to be anybody else.
No. Oh, you know who you are.
Mm-hmm. I've heard before that each person has a different color frequency. That's how people recognize them. When you're not being authentic, how does that affect the frequency that you are?
Your darker colors.
Mm-hmm.
It's gray. Grayish dark.
Hmm. Does that attract darkness too?
And if you're really bad, it's black.
It's black.
It's black.
Hmm.
Does that affect?
If you're not being authentic, if you're trying to be like everybody else and not being yourself, how does that affect your frequency?
Not good.
Not good.
It goes down, and then you're susceptible to being influenced.
Mm-hmm. By whom?
The dark.
Mm. So you need to really stay authentic, be strong in your own power.
Have faith.
Have faith.
Notice the miracles.
Notice the miracles.
They're here, they're everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Who causes these miracles to happen?
Call on Archangel Michael.
Mm-hmm.
Divine Source. The angels, archangels, the light beings.
Mm-hmm.
Our loved ones that have passed.
Mm-hmm. So Ari, how is it that you are related to this woman, Alexandra?
Part of each other.
Mm-hmm. She is part angel.
Ascending.
Mm-hmm. Would you be considered her higher self, or does she have a separate higher self?
Separate.
Very good. Do you have anything else to tell her today before we speak with her higher self?
Love
and light. Mm-hmm. Do you have a message for her?
Keep going. Stay strong. You are a healer. Just your presence influences the world.
Mm-hmm.
Don't let other people bring you down. Never let them steal your joy. Be brave. That's it.
Thank you very much, Ari. Good evening. I know you could have shown Alexandra many different lifetimes today, but you had her go to the light to meet her grandmother. And you had her see that life that she didn't want to see in World War II.
Mm-hmm.
What did you want to tell her about that?
She knows she's strong, but she's stronger than she thinks.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to be mean to be strong.
Mm-hmm.
Stay in that space of love and light.
Mm-hmm.
Always.
What is she supposed to be doing now as this woman, Alexandra? What's her purpose this time?
She has to open her gifts.
Mm-hmm.
And heal the planet.
How can she do that?
Her hands.
Mm-hmm. Did you activate her hands recently?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I guided her.
How can she activate it even more? She wants to be a channel.
Yoga.
Mm-hmm.
Meditation.
meditation. Can you begin opening that window today?
Yes.
Thank you. Now, we had spoken to Ari, the angel, but she wanted to know if she was a starseed.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What's the difference between what we think of, what is a starseed, in your opinion?
She comes from the light,
mm-hmm.
From the stars.
Mm-hmm. Is she from a certain planet?
Pleiades.
The Pleiades. What did she do there? What was her role in the Pleiades?
She was light.
Mm-hmm.
She had already ascended.
Mm-hmm.
And she helps. She chose to come down here to help with the shift.
With the shift.
Ascending.
Mm-hmm. Why did she choose such a difficult family?
She knows her strength.
Mm-hmm.
She learned the lessons. Anything can come at her. She can handle it.
Mm-hmm.
She is light.
Mm-hmm.
And they try, the dark forces, to get to her. They get her down, but they can't get through.
Mm-hmm. Did she know her father in a different lifetime?
Yes.
Who was he?
He was the Nazi.
Mm-hmm. I figured it was. What did she have to learn from that?
Forgive.
Mm-hmm. Was he the one doing the experiment on her?
Yes.
Is that why he's so angry at her all the time?
He hated her.
Mm-hmm.
He hated her because he could never get from her what he wanted.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, she was light. He couldn't take.
So in that lifetime as a Nazi and as a father, it was the same thing.
He tried to beat her down.
Mm-hmm. Make her suffer the same.
Suffer.
Mm-hmm.
But they were lessons.
What lessons did they have to learn from each other?
He can only go to the light.
Mm-hmm. Now, he passed.
He can only go to the light.
Mm-hmm.
She taught him the light.
Did he go to the light when he transitioned?
Yes, she helped him.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, she forgave him. She forgave him. She gave him the strength. She was there.
Mm-hmm. Is she holding any connection that would be hurting her in future relationships?
Oh, she still feels hurt.
Mm-hmm.
She feels hurt.
How can we help her today to disconnect from that?
Heal. She can heal. She mm-hmm. can heal.
So can we begin the healing process today?
It has started.
Good. What are you using for the healing?
I'm surrounding her with love and light.
Wonderful.
He can't harm her ever, ever again anymore.
Very good.
She knows that. She needs to know that. She needs to know that.
Mm-hmm. Is their contract over?
Yes.
Good. Did he do anything today? Can you help her? Can Archangel Raphael help?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Her third eye.
Her third eye. Let's do that.
Oh.
Can we get Archangel Raphael involved with you?
Yes.
All right. have him work on all of those things that she needs to do to heal so that she can help heal others.
It is so
wonderful. Thank you so much. What is she supposed to be doing?
Helping others through quantum healing.
Okay, so this is something that she should work on?
Yoga channeling.
In the channeling?
Channeling.
Is she actually doing automatic writing?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. No. She doubted herself.
Needs to prepare.
Mm-hmm. What kind of preparation?
More meditation.
Okay.
Prior to.
Mm-hmm.
And more healing.
Well, she has a problem with meditation. Can you help her with that?
Go back to yoga.
Go back to yoga.
Become a yoga instructor.
Okay, she can do that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Good, and that will help her meditate, open up her third eye?
Yes, uh-huh. And heals others in the process.
Wonderful.
Of doing that.
Okay. So she's supposed to be a channel.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me how the remote viewing affects her in this life? The one where she was a Polish girl, remote viewing.
That was just to bring her awareness.
Mm-hmm.
She knows.
Mm-hmm.
She knows. And to flourish her gifts.
Mm-hmm. Does she have other gifts that you haven't told
them
you?
Come out. And mm-hmm. Yes, she's mm-hmm. afraid. Really, she needs to let go of that.
Tell her what gift she has.
Telepathy.
Mm-hmm.
Healing abilities. She can heal just with her thoughts.
Wonderful.
And she has a direct beam of light from divine source.
What color is this light?
So white.
So white.
So white.
Is she always connected to this beam of light?
Yes.
Okay. So she knows she always has access to this information.
Yes, unless she goes into her fear zone.
Mm-hmm. Can we ask her angel, Ari, to help her with that so that she doesn't go into that fear zone?
Yes.
Thank you. She's asking about her job. She wants to know if she should move.
North Florida.
North Florida. Mm-hmm.
She knows that.
Okay.
She will either be based at Houston
mm-hmm.
or in Virginia.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good.
It's gonna happen soon.
Okay, good, wonderful. Would you do a scan on her body, please?
Mm-hmm.
Tell her what's going on with her body, beginning with her eyes.
Yeah. Her eyes, it's part of the shift.
Mm-hmm. What's going on with them? Is it a vibrational thing?
Yes, they are adjusting
mm-hmm.
to the new vibrations.
Mm-hmm.
Throat.
Mm-hmm. What's going on with her throat?
She needs to eat healthier.
Okay, what is she not supposed to be eating?
She eats a lot of chocolate.
A lot of chocolate?
Yeah.
So cut down on that?
Yes, make smoothies.
Make smoothies? Okay.
She can heal it.
Good, good. Can I request on her behalf a spirit coach for her, a guide that will help her with her nutrition so that she selects the right foods.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Reminds her of what she should and shouldn't eat.
Yes, we're also giving her more time.
Mm-hmm.
So she's not running around all the time.
Wonderful.
And she can get healthier.
Mm-hmm.
She knows it.
What's going on with her spine?
She overdoes it. Oh, she's little. She's strong, and then sometimes she doesn't know her limits.
Mm-hmm. So what would you like to tell her about that?
Do the yoga.
Do the yoga, it'll help?
Eat healthier. You're getting lighter and stronger.
Good. Can we get some adjustment of her spine today so that she doesn't feel any discomfort?
Yes.
Thank you very much. What about her knees? What's happening there?
She's overdoing it too.
Mm-hmm. What is she stressing her knees with?
Her negative energy is going there.
Ah. Has she created any thought forms there?
No.
Mm-hmm. It's just stressing it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you alleviate that today?
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. It's being done already.
Wonderful. You had already told her about the throat, that was part of the shift?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What about her hyperactive thyroid? Is it the same thing?
The doctors are just trying to get her on drugs.
Mm-hmm. It seems to me a lot of people seem to have issues with their thyroid right now. What's going on with that?
It is part of the ascension,
mm-hmm.
but it's also all the chemicals.
Mm-hmm.
And food and the air, they are bombarding us right now because they know. They know that the light is winning.
Mm-hmm. What do they bombard us with?
Chemicals
mm-hmm.
that are harsh to your body and to your senses. They want to numb your senses.
Mm-hmm. How can we help with that? What can we do ourselves?
As a collective, you need to stay positive,
mm-hmm.
and through thought form, you can change everything.
Okay.
Believe in it. Trust it. It works.
Wonderful. So we ourselves can create that reality of a better world and a cleaner world.
Oh, yes, you are manifesting now,
mm-hmm.
at a greater, faster rate.
Mm-hmm. There seems to be a lot of, right now, voices of people who are dissatisfied and are trying to voice their opinions more than ever. Is that helping the world?
They're just crazy. Stand in who you are and what you are.
Mm-hmm.
Don't be dissuaded.
Mm-hmm.
Naysayers.
Naysayers, okay. So continue to always be in the light.
You are light.
Mm-hmm. Good. She's asking about her pineal gland and her heart to mind connection. She wants to clear that. Can you do that for her?
Yes.
Okay. Tell her what you're using to.
Source light.
Thank you. Tell me when you're done.
It is so.
Thank you. Does Archangel Michael have a message for her today?
He loves her.
Mm-hmm.
Always with her. He cares a lot for her. He watches over her.
Mm-hmm.
Always with you.
That's wonderful. Is there anything that I could have asked that I didn't ask?
The Ascension.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to tell me about the Ascension?
New energies are coming in to help everyone.
New energies are coming in? Mm-hmm. Where are these energies coming from?
Divine source.
Okay.
And everyone is working on this, even the extraterrestrials.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone is helping.
Mm-hmm.
They want this to happen. They want to save as many as we possibly can.
These extraterrestrials, are they in our space at this time?
Yes, but most of us cannot see them.
Mm-hmm. Why is it that
we don't want to see them?
We don't want to see them.
We don't want to see them. We're shut down.
We're shut down. How many of these space ships are there?
Thousands, thousands.
Thousands. Around the globe?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Are these small or large?
Some are small, some are large.
Mm-hmm. And are they there to receive us or to help us? What is the purpose of these spaceships?
They are holding the energy and they're helping us.
Mm-hmm.
Help with the ascension.
Okay. Are any of them helping with our environment? For example, chemtrails and things like that.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm. How do they help with that?
They put nets, energy fields out. And they are instructing us to heal the planet.
The star seeds are receiving this information.
Yes.
Very good. So do you have a message for all the star seeds out there that are here for this purpose right now to heal the planet? What would you like to tell all of the star seeds?
Stay strong in your conviction that this will happen, and you are doing a great job. Keep your faith. Avoid everything that causes fear within you, and you need to come together. You need to come together in groups because it makes it that much stronger, the energy that much stronger.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Now when...
Stay in the light.
When someone is watching a video of mine that is channeling information from the divine, what is that doing to the star seeds that are watching, and consequently to the planet? How does that help?
It raises the vibration.
Mm-hmm.
It raises the light and healing.
Mm-hmm.
It helps with what is going on
mm-hmm.
at this time in the planet.
So they are actually receiving the same healing that the client is receiving?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And more. We're reaching out.
Very good.
You're helping that. Thank you.
Thank you for allowing me to do that. I guess I signed up for this.
You were born for this.
That's a tall order.
You know it.
Yeah. Thank you.
You're an angel on earth, and you know that.
Okay, so thank you very much for that. Anything else that you have for Alexandra?
Stay in the love space. Stay in the love space.
Thank you so much for all of the information. I'd like to thank all of the angels that are assisting today. I really appreciate it, and I know she will, for sure. Wide awake, feeling wonderful. Welcome back. How do you feel?
I feel great.
What do you remember?
I think I remember everything. But it was weird because I felt like I was there.
You were here and there?
I was, yeah.
Now, you did not want to visit that World War II life. And we did.
I did.
How do you think that helped you?
It helped, yeah.
It was amazing. It was pretty tough to experience, but you realized what you were, how strong you were. A lot of powers then, and then you have powers now. How long do you feel you're on this journey?
An hour.
About an hour and 15 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah, you did great. So, what do you want to do? You want to share this? It seemed to be a lot of information for the world.
We edit stuff out.
Okay.
We edit personal information out, so any personal information that was revealed will be edited out, but I think it's a great thing for all of those people that need to heal there.
Okay. So we just went through a very beautiful experience, except for a few parts that were a little crazy there, a little tough. So tell everybody what it felt like to be in hypnosis.
I felt very relaxed, and I almost felt like I was here, but I wasn't.
Mm-hmm.
But I highly recommend it.
And now that you've done it, you were thinking of becoming a practitioner yourself. So how does this affect you now that you've done this?
I have to do it.
You were told you have to do it.
I have to do it.
So now you can help other people too.
And I feel like I actually knew more than what I thought I did.
Yeah. I mean, you've been doing this healing all along. And that's what you came onto the planet. What about your father, now that you understand? Because you had told me before that he used to chase you around the table and try to find, you know, get you. And how was the realization when you realized that this was the same person that was this Nazi?
I realized he didn't get me.
Mm-hmm.
He wasn't able to. He couldn't.
In either life. That's something. So sometimes our enemies come back. We come back with living the life with our enemies as our family. You wonder, why do we feel that way about a parent or a sister or a brother? And it's because we haven't really resolved things. We had to learn things. So how does that make you feel differently now?
I feel healed.
Mm-hmm.
I feel healed. It makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's what's beautiful about these sessions is you have no idea. You came for one thing, and you received a totally different experience than you expected, I think.
Yes.
Good.
I'm sorry, I'm still like...
I know, you're like still floating around.
Together.
In fact, I'm going to give you, where is it? The shungite to ground you right now. Hold on to that. So you can have the grounding effect. So if you want a session with me here in Miami, or... traveling around, you can go to albaweinman.com. It's very easy to book it.
Yes.
I travel around the country, so if you want to do a session with me, go to my out of town page. You can see where I'm going to next. My sessions do book very quickly, so I would recommend you sign up for my newsletter so that you know where I'll be going to, and you can sign up quickly. So until the next time, thank you for watching, and we'll see you soon. Bye. You hug.
Aww. Thank you so much.
Oh, it's beautiful.